Thank you so much for all of you being here on concert tonight, number 1.5. Thank you for your patience and your flexibility as we had to take time to situate some other weather issues that had happened for school groups to make sure that we could be here tonight. So thank you very much. We do have all these lovely flowers, congratulations, to spruce it up a little bit. And thank you to Mrs. Anderson and Mrs. Queen for allowing us to borrow those and use it to clean up the space. At the end, if you would like to come down and take some things and make some flowers, you're more than welcome to make some bouquets this evening. We just need you to not take the boxes that they're in, but you're more than welcome because they're literally going to go in the garbage and that would be sad. So please take home a few flowers to brighten up your home. If you would double check right now, last week we had a number of issues. You're going to have to reset, turn off your cell phones, and then cell phones turn off, and cell phones turn off, and cell phones turn off. Please, 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 please. They've worked really hard, and they're excited to put on a performance for you this evening. We are in the gym again, which sometimes reminds us that we're in the gym and we want to run around. Please stay seated if they're playing and try to move in and out only when we're in between pieces. If you made it to the concert last week, you already got to hear the jazz band, so we're not going to have them play again. We'll just expedite things a little bit this evening, so you can skip that if you're looking at your program. And we're going to go right to the High School Symphonic Band and open with On Wings of Eagles, conducted by Mrs. Bain. called, Urban Dances. The seniors chose this piece each year. They let the seniors vote and they get to repeat one song that they've played at some point in their career. They chose this one. It was from their freshman year, which was COVID. They'd made it to state contest, and then we never got to go to state contest. We had finished pre-state the day before everything shut down. So this is a piece that we normally would have worked on from like January all the way until March and April. And we put it together in very few rehearsals and have done an outstanding job with it. It's called Urban Dances. You'll hear city sounds. The percussion is featured heavily. Lots of different sounds you might hear in the city. Hopefully it will paint a picture for you. They've done a really good job of putting it together. So here we are with Urban Dances.
Thank you. This piece takes us through a thrilling journey involving light and dark, love and despair, and goodness, joy, and hope. Lastly, it has been a marvelous experience teaching all of these students. I hope they have learned as much from me as I have learned from them. So students, thank you for all the warm-ups, gratitudes, and all the efforts you've made to help me feel welcome. Thank you, Mrs. Kaufman and Ms. Van Riffle for the mentorship and guidance, and thank you all for supporting your students. Now join us on this technically and musically intense work, When Angels Weep.
Thank you.
time except for one.
Yeah.
It's all right. She was taking a nap. It's okay. Anything to embarrass her one more time.
Yes.
All right, I'm going to turn this over. Then we give them all a round of applause.
Thank you.
to thank you for an outstanding year. These kids put in a lot of work and a lot of effort, but we know that comes from a whole lot of support at home. So thank you very much for everything you do. The taxi rides, the late nights, the ridiculous long waits at OU when we were trapped. None of this is always convenient, and I understand that and appreciate that. So without you, none of this happens. So thank you very much. Give your parents and friends and family a round of applause, please. Chose at the beginning of the year to kind of guide our principles this entire year were dedication, inclusivity, and respect. They chose those on their own, and they have embodied all three of those words all year long, and I think those are three pretty admirable words to live up to, and they've done an outstanding job. This is our final performance together as a band, because 10 of them, of course, have graduated already and are gracing us with their presence. And on Monday, we start Spring Brand, and we bring in a whole new crop of rookies, and it all starts over again. So this is a really, really special time for us. We're grateful to be a part of a community that supports us and a school that supports us. I want to thank Mr. Barnes, our superintendent, and the school board again for everything they do for us. Mr. Jackson and Mrs. Anderson are outstanding principals to work for. We have a wonderful staff, Ms. Billiou, and it's been a sounding board for us. So new choir teacher, if you have a better, the kids should sing. Some of these kids need to sing.
Yeah, they do.
So she's done a wonderful job, so I would encourage you to have your students get involved with her as well. I want to thank Mrs. Vanderbilt, Mr. Romine, Mr. Winn. It's been wonderful working with them, and looking forward to it. Well, except for Mr. Winn, he's already got a new job. We don't like him anymore. We're here about 5 minutes, so no, I'm just kidding. We already got marching days, a copy of mom. So we're ready to go for a new year, starting here in just a minute, and it's different on day. Our closing piece tonight is really fitting for us, is Choose Joy. We've taken a lot of time this year to make sure we're recognizing our gratitudes, making we're realizing that even when things are not what that we always want them to be, that there's something to be grateful for every morning, and that's what we started our day with. This is the second piece we performed for state contests, and they've really made it sparkle. The best compliment I got from a retired band director who heard it said, I played this piece with my groups, and I've heard it many times, but until your band played it, I've never heard it played well. That's incredible. It features solos by Sadie Crawford on flute, Emma Nelson on alto sax, and Katie Hamilton on clarinet. It's a great piece to end a concert with, and I hope you enjoy listening to it as much as we've enjoyed putting it together.